don't know what you've been told. But I don't get out much these days. Waking young and feeling all the days are no longer my own. To piss away the waking hours. But don't.
Welcome to the Yay Sarah Jane podcast. It's really good to be here and really good to finally record this. I have had it in mind for quite some time, but just didn't have the oomph to do it yet, or didn't have the time. I'm in France at the moment, at my parents' house. We come here several times a year. They've lived here for years and years and years, so it feels like home. I live in Holland with my family, my husband and three boys. We live in the woods in the centre of Holland, in a national park, and I am a natural dyer of wool. My company, Atelier Sarah Jane, dyes Dutch wool naturally, and it's just me. So I wanted to show you some of my wool and talk a little bit about the colours and why I choose to dye just Dutch wool. I will talk a little bit about the rest of my craft and about some projects that I've been on my needles, off my needles, So I'll start with my wool. I actually dye on two bases. I dye on the fingering weight base. This is a natural colourway called Sailor. Sort of pinkish colour. And I dye on the sort of worsted weight, yarn type thickness, which is this colour. It's not this colour, this base. I dye lots of colours. What I wanted to explain or show you is that the fun is that I dye on three different bases. This one is dyed on the natural base, this one is the light grey, and this one is the dark grey. The wool is really rustic type wool. It's very strong, very squishy, very soft. It doesn't actually itch, but it feels rustic all the same. So if you knit a garment, you can wear it around your neck if you're not too sensitive to wool. It doesn't have an itch, it just has a sort of firmness about it. The wool is from a sheep called the Tesselaar, and it's the Blauwe Tesselaar is the dark one, which is the blue Tesselaar, I don't really know how to translate it. And then the grey and the natural colour are a mix of them both. Obviously the natural is just a white sheep. And the Tesselaar, I get my yarn from a company which is on an island in the north of Holland called Texel, hence the Tesselaar. And it is a sheep island. There's probably more sheep than inhabitants. And this is a company who makes wool, gets wool spun up, and also has a range of lanolin products like sunscreen, hand creams, that sort of thing. And it's called Noordkroon, and I've been going to Texel for years and years and years, every year. It's a beautiful island, and it's just got it's just amazing place to go. And there's this little cafe I go, which is called Novalis, and they always sell the wool. And then when I was there in February, I just contacted the company and asked if I could get some of their wool on wholesale to dye on, and yeah, they said yes. So I'm really, really happy with that. And I've decided only to dye Dutch wool for the moment. actually, that's not completely true. To dye Dutch wool for my for Atelier Sarah Jane, for the brand Atelier Sarah Jane, because I know I can dye on merino and all sorts of things, and I will try that if I can find some which has its origins in Holland. But I would just love to get this product on the market more and show off our stuff, because it's pretty amazing. And the wool, when you've knitted a garment with it, it just lasts forever and ever and ever. It's just beautiful. It stays really strong and sturdy, and yeah, it has a beautiful feel. So I'm really enjoying it, and yeah, I will show you some of the projects I've made with this. The first project I will talk about is my the Hali Waistcoat. This is a project that I've done in together with VIllava. VIllava is the designer of the waistcoat. She has up to now done for adults sweaters, and for children bonnets and waistcoats, but this is the first waistcoat for an adult. So I'll just show you the waistcoat a little bit. So yeah, it has a nice high front neck, and then it goes down, and then on the back there's beautiful short rows which give it a really fun shaping. I used different colours, and I made a sort of a really intuitive stripe, and the one she made is in my blue colour. She made one up in this blue, which is called Man, which is moon in English. Yeah, and I have some kits still available in my shop, but also I do encourage people to just find your own kit, find your colours, and then contact me to get the discount code for the kit. You can get the pattern via VIllava and the wool via me. So, really lovely project to knit, and I think this just goes over everything. It goes over dresses, it goes on jeans. It's just the most versatile piece of clothing I have in my cupboard at the moment. And I wear it a lot, and I have worn it a lot. So, but you can see the wool just stays really sort of beautiful, and I love that about it. So that's a really lovely project, so go check it out if you like it. And then my next one, which is my FO finished object, is my half sail shawl by Bantry Yarns. So this is a shawl from an Irish designer, and it is done in my fingering weight yarn. Oh, I'm showing the back, which doesn't really matter, but it's nice to see the front. Fingering weight yarn, and together with some mohair. And I think this creates a really lovely fabric, and it just goes all the way into a point there, and yeah, I really love it. I was started making this because I was going to Woolen Yarn Festival in Ireland, and I really wanted to make a project from an Irish designer. So there are lots of videos on the Woolen site, and also on Hey Brown Berry's vlogs. She was the one who documented the festival with me knitting this, because I finished it when I was there, and there's some photos on Instagram of me on the beach near Dublin flaunting it. So that's really cool, and it's just a really, it has a story for me now, which I love. And so Woolen was really excited, because in the weeks before Woolen, or maybe a month before Woolen, I got into contact with Cross & Wood's crafting parlour, and they decided to take some of my wool to Woolen. So that was super exciting, because they are my first wholesale shop. So you can, if you want to have a look and feel at my yarns, you can go to them, because their shop is just amazing. They have a really, really beautiful range of yarns and fabrics. They have the patterns by Merchant and Mills, if you're a sewer, and you know, any sewer would know that that's really great. I have the Merchant and Mills book, and I've made lots of their projects. So mohair and my rustic wool go really well together. So I can show you lots of my wool. Obviously the colours I make a big range of colours. This is one of the kits for the Hali, actually, that I put together. It's like a pinky with a heathered pink, And then the Freya color, which is a natural color with some speckles and stripes. This is a kit for the, yeah, I'm going back to the Hali again, kit for the large, the extra large size. But as I say, you can just swap things around. I decided to start selling both the 100 gram skeins and the 50 gram skeins in my shop, because I thought this yarn is also really attractive for colour work. It makes a really tight and densely woven fabric. It just knits together and it's just really beautiful. I am starting a colour work project soon. I'm starting the leaf sweater by Knit Love Wool, so I'll put photos of that, of my process on Instagram, and you can see. So yeah, it's choices, 100 gram or 50 gram, and obviously if you have 50 gram, you can switch colours, change colours. All my wool is online at the moment, except these two. These two will come, you know, I didn't have any time before I left on holiday, and I didn't want to do it here because I wanted to photograph it in the same setting. But these two colours, it's like a green-greyish colour and green-grey with some light and dark and pinkish speckles. I've had lots of fun about the name of these skeins. I love naming my skein wool on my colorways, actually. I love it. I always have so much words and I love reading, and I love a language, and I love names. So all the names of my skeins, I have had a really happy process in naming them. So this, I asked some people on Instagram, so what should I name the colour? And some said Sage, and some said really long names, but it's become Sago. So Sago soon will be online. The next thing I wanted to talk about are my drop spindles. I did a fibre swap with a Hay Brown Berry at Woolen Yarn Festival. She took from me from America some America Tunis fiber, which I haven't processed yet, and I took for her some Dutch Marshland sheep free translation wool, and we'd had a really lovely moment of exchanging that, which is on one of her vlogs, if you want to go and check it out. And I got really interested in the drop spindling because I have a spinning wheel, and I have done quite a lot of spinning, but obviously, you know, only in the last year, so I'm a newbie spinner, but I love it. And then she told me, she showed some of her spindles in one of her vlogs, and I really got curious. So I made some. I made three sizes, and in the end, I decided to put one of the hooks on the top. Well, depends what you find the top at the bottom, and the other one's here, just to see what the difference is, because I literally have no idea. And this one I decorated with some wooden burn thing my son has. And so I have three different sizes, the largest size and then the medium size and then the shorter and smaller size. And I'm just, you know, I'm just using them all to see what the difference is, and I'm really enjoying it. I'm really, really enjoying it. It's really calming, and it's a real slow process, obviously much slower than the wheel is, but it gives you a sense of the feeling of the wool more, and you get to concentrate more on the way you draft, and I think that's really interesting. So I have been able to spin thinner on these than I have on my wheel. Maybe that's because it takes, you have more time sort of to draft, and I don't know. So what I've spun up here literally is only about 20 grams, but you know, it's really sweet, and it's not perfect. It doesn't need to be perfect. It's about the process, and it's about the learning, and it's about the wool. I've combined two different kinds of wool. I've bought Merino d'Arles, which is a French wool, and some Dutch marshland. So I've combined them together to see how that works. I made some carding tools as well at home, but I'm really wanting one of those carding wheels so I can make maybe braids. And obviously it would be awesome to naturally dye them and then make some braids and then put them up in my shop. But I'm not there yet. But I do have lots of wool at home, be it, you know, Dutch wool that has been donated to me or that I've bought. Or so it's just the process that needs to sort of, I need to put into action really. So I have seen a tutorial of how to make your own drum carder. So I'm going to have a closer look at it. I might try it myself, or I might get a carpenter friend to make it for me to see if I could do that, because the new ones are quite expensive. So I like to try my hand at DIY. I'm just having a look at what else. There's one project which is on my needles, which I'll show you, and then I'll show you some sewing, and then I think that'll be it for my first episode. I'll just grab the one that's just on my needles, which is a huge project, and it's the only one actually that I took on holiday, but I am loving it. And I mean, it's a really well-known project, so I think it needs no introduction, but I will introduce it. This is the Penguono by Stephen West, and it is knit up all in my own worsted weight yarns. So you start here with the seed stitch on the back, and you work your way around from the sides to the front. These are my front panels. And again, I've knitted this up really intuitively. I've just put lots of small balls of yarn in a bag and things that I'd done little projects with, or that I tried out, or, you know, half of a 100-gram skein. One goes in the shop and the other one I used for this. This is some of the yarn which was left over from my Bantry yarns, half sail shawl. So I held this fingering yarn weight together, which is also an option for the Hali waistcoat, if you see, because it knits up quite the same as the worsted weight. So again, these are two skeins, two strands held together, and with my yellow, which I love my yellow. I'm gonna go and dye up lots more yellow. So yeah, and then you have the, it's a bit of a thing to hold up, the sleeves, and I'm just onto the second sleeve at the moment. So in the end, and then I'll do the beautiful, which I love, the short row neckline, and then another row on the bottom. And this is just, for me, it is just Atelier Sarah Jane showpiece, and it's just that I have so enjoyed all the colors that I've dyed up, and the process, thinking about the process that I've been through starting up my shop, and, you know, just, yeah, amazing. And I love the welts as well. I think that's really original and really was really fun to knit. So I show pictures of everything I do on Instagram. And on my Ravelry page. I try to be active on Ravelry, but I just don't have a lot of time to keep it all up. But I just recently put all my project on there, and yeah, try to keep up. I'm in a lot of groups as well, which is so much fun. I try and do knit alongs and everything because I love to chat and I love to see everybody else's projects. And I am still I'm still doing the, I don't even know if it's still running actually, but I'm still knitting on my Dirty Lace shawl by Truly Myrtle. It's an amazing shawl, it's a lovely pattern, and it's just been so much fun seeing everybody's colour choices and seeing what they've, how fast they knitted up, and someone that got into trouble and ripped back, and it's just, and we all support each other, and it's really fun. So if you're not in any groups on Ravelry, I'd do recommend you go and have a look. So yeah, I think that's the knitting part. I was wondering if I should tell you a little bit about my knitting story. My mum keeps saying everybody, well, she was knitting since she was three. And I think that's true. I had an English grandmother who came over to Holland quite often, and I was always knitting with her. And then I had an English aunt. She knitted loads of like bears and yeah. People ordered from her as well. She couldn't knit enough of them, like puppets and dolls and really beautiful stuff. I still have some at home. It's really precious. And then I, obviously, when I went to school and university, I got out of it a little bit, and then I just, I think I went into crochet first again. And then I started knitting again, and since we've been living out of the city, I've been knitting more and more. So I think it's just an amazing craft, and all the things you can do with it, and you can learn. And the thing that I've been trying to master is to really understand my knitting, to understand the stitches, understand what happens when I use a stitch to the fabric. So what happens to a seed stitch? How does it look? How does it look if I turn it around and, you know, insert the needle in the back instead of in the front? And what, so that I always, from a pattern, it takes a time until you understand what the designer means. And I love that. And suddenly at one moment you just get it, and then you just go, and it's just so relaxing. And yeah, I have a million projects that I would like to do. And I already have some on the needles at home as well. I used to be just a one project girl, and then at one point I just thought, I have such an urge to cast on, let's just do it. And I just had so much fun. And some of them I finished, some of them I didn't finish. And then I always, at one point I say, okay, I've done enough sweaters. I'm gonna do just socks for the whole family. I just wanna do socks. But then I start that, and then halfway the sock, or I'm in the second at the second sock, and I think, okay, I think it's time for a shawl or a sweater. And it's fun. It's fun. You can do whatever you want. You don't need to get stressed. You can leave a project, pick it up later. I really love it. Obviously, I was just talking about color work. Yeah, so this is my Sipila sweater. Pattern is by Boyland Knitworks. It's a short sleeve, yoked color work, and I knitted up in Malabrigo Sock. I think this aubergine type eggplant, it's called eggplant, we call it aubergine, but it's eggplant, and I don't really know, I can't remember the name of this one, but it's a really beautiful design and a lovely fit, because it's quite wide around the shoulders. You don't get any tension here, and it's really loose fit, and I love it. I wear it all the time. I wear it with long sleeves underneath in the winter, or underneath another cardigan, and I wear it in the summer when it's not too hot. But I really love it, so I've worn it lots, and the fabric stayed really well. So Malabrigo yarn, I think that's a really good one too. I would love to do another one, long sleeve version, in my wool and see how that comes out. So I think I've talked about lots of things. Obviously, I will put everything I talk about in the description box below. And if you have any questions or remarks or comments, do just ask. So sewing, I am going back home tomorrow. And so I've already packed my sewed bag, but I'm gonna show it to you anyway. So this is, it's huge. I completely disappear behind it. In the beginning of July, it was my birthday, and I got this urge just to make everybody of my household a bag, and I did. I made everybody a duffel bag. So it's just the round shape at the front and at the back, and then, yeah, sorry, that was something in between. And then the straps all the way around, and then I did everybody a pocket on this side. I got my fabric at a little fabric shop near me, and I just chose what I loved, and you know, it's like this woven fabric, and I really love it. And so Purl Soho, I just did it from my, it's got a zipper on top. And I actually just cut out the rounds, the circles, and then measured the I measured them, and then I just got my fabric to add to that, and then I just did it, and it was really simple. But I know that Purl Soho does a really good duffel bag pattern, also in a different shape, which I really love as well. So I put them underneath. So if you'd like a template, or you find it easier to sew like that, then go and have a look at that. But I love it. And I just got my youngest boy is 4 years old, and I made all the boys one, and my husband, and it's got the same rounded sides, and then the hemp rope straps, and a zipper. I did him a metal zipper so it would be a little bit stronger. I don't know if you can see that. Yeah. And his pocket is in a little bear, really cute bear print. And I did him a little drawstring bag for his headphones in the same fabric, so he looks really cool. We all look really cool. And then I have a son who's 10 years old. He's really into robots, so I did him a robot fabric. And then I have a 13-year-old son. He's going on to 14, so I did him quite sort of a cooler version with a leather key strap and not to left out all the childlike things. So he loved it, which is a really big compliment, because he is hard to make something for. He has his own style and, you know, he doesn't really want anything handmade. But he loved it. So everybody's taking their bags on holiday and I was really chuffed. And they were all really happy that I made them something for my birthday, because I'd hid all the packages in the house. And in the morning when they gave me my presents, I said, you guys go and have a look in the house. And they all found their little present, their big present. And they were really happy. So that was really fun to do. I love sewing. I try and sew everything that I make or knit or, you know, actually straight down to my underwear, which is just really fun. There's so many cool patterns and really clear descriptions that you can get these days. So I've made coats and jumpsuits. I'm a big jumpsuit lover, so I think I'll do a jumpsuit issue or episode, part of an episode next time, to show you the jumpsuits that I've made and what my experiences are with them and what I will make in the future. I think I've made 4 or 5 jumpsuits already, and it's just a really versatile piece which you can just put on and it looks really stylish and it wears really comfortably. So I'm really into sewing. I love it. And I did sew bags about 4 or 5 years ago. I will put them up in the shop as project bags, but I don't think I'm hesitant to start making sewing for sale as well, because there are so many cool things out there already that I think I'll just stick to the dyeing, because obviously I'm a mother of 3 and that is a pretty busy home life as well. My kids don't go to any daycare centers or anything, or obviously they're at school, but in the afternoon I'm there and I help with the homework and I help with I'm just the at-home mum as well, which I really enjoy and I love. So that's a little bit about me. If you have any questions or any comments, do leave them. I am in the process of writing a newsletter as well. You can subscribe to that on my website, which is, I'll put links on below, which is my webshop as well. So, and I'll talk in more depth about my dyeing process and the colours and, So I think that's it. I think I'm going to leave it there. It was really lovely doing this. I enjoyed it. And I hope when I look back, my boys won't laugh, but I'm sure they'll be very helpful this time. I will put some photos and videos in the front, which you've already seen, and in the back of the episode. I've found some pictures of the sheep in Tessel and some of my spinning and lots of things. So I hope to see you next time. Goodbye. Don't let them go. Don't.